Hi everybody, welcome. I'm Glina and today we are going to be doing something different. Today's video we are going to be doing a speed build of this Solani beach house, modern beach house that I built. And you guys are going to see every process of me building this house. And I prefer using this speed build method because it's easier and faster for me to edit. I will do more of the video just like how I usually did it, but today is going to be different because I am still adjusting to my work and editing the video. So I didn't have much time because the editing usually took me a really long time. Usually when I record video, it will take me minimum 4 hours of building up to 10 hours. So can you guys imagine me editing 10 hours footage? It's going to take a really long time. For this one, I built it around 4 hours plus, almost 5 hours. This build is actually inspired by a picture that I saw on Pinterest, and it's a modern house. It wasn't a beach house, but I was just thinking maybe it would be nice to place it in Solani. And as you guys can see right here, I built it on the other way first because the entrance is actually at the back side. But when I'm building this, I flip the front into facing the ocean because as you guys can see here, the lot is surrounded by terrain. And in The Sims, whenever you are building with terrain all over you, all around you, it's going to be harder because your camera is gonna keep on going up and it's going to be annoying. So I just flip it first while I'm doing the front, and then later I'm going to flip it around to the correct facing. Right here I'm struggling with the roof. I was trying to make it interesting, but I gave up. I didn't continue that. I just continue with the simpler roofing because I was thinking that, oh my god, it's not possible to do that kind of roofing in The Sims. So I decided to go with this one, which I think is still looking nice, and I kind of like how it turned out actually. So for this one, I am going to be placing a garage downstairs, and I'm going to be using base game window just how you can see right here. Right now I'm placing it, and I know that we don't have cars and things like that, but the pictures that I saw on Pinterest, the build is actually having the garage. I actually didn't furnish the bottom floor, so if you guys download this house from the gallery, you can actually make it into whatever you like. You can make it into a party place, or you can make it into, I don't know, a game room or a bowling space even. You can do that because it's quite big downstairs. So yeah, I'm just trying to make the exterior look interesting right here. You'll see me mix and matching the wall, I don't know, the bricks and the wood plank. I just think that the two mixed together kind of makes it looks interesting. And yeah, I am doing the landscaping right now. You guys now can see how I do the landscape because usually I just cut it in my video. And usually what I did is I just take a look at the surrounding, and then I see which plants, which bushes that they use around, and then I use the same thing into my build because I want to make it seamless, make it looks like it belongs in the lot with the surrounding. Oh my god, look at the ocean at the back there. I am actually using a preset, a reshader, and it's so nice, it's so beautiful because honestly the previous one is not looking that blue, but with this shader it's everything is just so bright, and Solani is a much better place. It's just so beautiful. I really like doing the terrain painting because it really brings everything alive. It makes everything better, it makes everything looks more nicer. And now I am actually changing the wallpaper into white, the exterior, because I always saw these pictures on Instagram, on Pinterest, where these beach houses have like a white exterior, but after after that, I decided not to go with it because it looks kind of plain for the Sims world. It doesn't look like it belong, because the Sims doesn't absorb the lighting from the exterior. You know, with in the real world, the white is going to look like a bit bluish whenever it's sunny outside because it's reflecting the sky and things like that. Yeah. So I didn't go with the white and I go back to the previous color that I picked. And I am just doing a little bit of, I don't know, decoration here and there with the plants, because with this kind of modern house, you, as you guys can see here, the shape is very minimal and it's very not detailed with the craftsman styles or that kind of houses. You can make it more interesting with the bumps out here and there, but with this kind of modern house, you cannot really do that. So I just make it more alive and make it more interesting with the plants. And I also use this roof pieces to kind of make the ramp go into the garage. And yeah, I'm doing the back part right here. Actually, the picture that I saw on Pinterest didn't have the back part. It only has the picture of the front. So I was just thinking, oh, maybe because we're in Salani, it's going to be interesting if we make a pool area. Not the kind of pool that you would want to swim in, but this kind of pool where you can just dip around, I don't know. Where you can just dip your feet or just, I don't know, in Indonesia we call it berendam. Soak, I don't know. Oh my god, that's so weird. Okay, usually I Google it, but now I'm doing the voiceover real time, I cannot Google it. Okay, so yeah, that's that. You can put your feet into the water, that's what I mean. So yeah, I was just thinking to make it look a little bit more interesting, on the left side here I put some lounging area where you can sit and lay down and listening to music, because I put a couple of speakers there, and I just thought it looks really nice. Usually when I'm building a house, I always hated it at first because it doesn't look as nice, but after doing the landscaping, the wallpaper, the flooring and everything, it looks much better. And right here you saw in the interior, I put a couple of furniture just to mark the area. For example, the bedroom, I'm going to put the bed in there, the dining room, I put the dining table and so on. And right here I am kind of lost, I didn't know what kind of kitchen that I want to make. So you guys see that it's all white, and I changed the fridge and the stove, and afterwards I'm going to change the countertops. I love this piece from Dream Home Decorator. I cannot live without Dream Home Decorator, Eco Lifestyle and also Snowy Escape, because those packs, and also Country Living, those packs are just beautiful. Oh my god, if you guys compare it to the earlier packs that they released, the qualities, you can see the difference in the quality. I just thought that it's interesting, they're getting better, but obviously the previous packs, we cannot expect them to update that as well. And I just used this fences from Eco Lifestyle. I just thought it gives an interesting look, and I'm going to change it into blue afterwards, because I am going for the colors that is I'm going for the mix of colors of green, yellow and blue in this kitchen. And I was struggling with the flooring on the dining area, but I decided to go with this concrete floor to make it simple, and then we're gonna warm it up with the rug afterwards later. And also the mismatch chair. I really like to do that, I don't know why. And also I always go towards the more colorful side of the build usually lately. Oh my god, my English. I try to keep the cluttering into minimal in this house, because I feel like this is the kind of house where you will use it for Airbnb. You're gonna rent it out to other people, and obviously you want to keep it into a minimal, the decoration and everything. I didn't put any TV on this living room because I was just thinking that this can be the place where you go hang out and talk to your family or friends whenever you're staying here. So I didn't put any TV here. This is a place where you talk, not watch TV. And because we have a movie room at the back. So yeah, I tried to make this place an Instagrammable place. I don't know if that's a right word or not, but I try to make it Instagrammable. When you come into this Airbnb, you're gonna want to take pictures on every corner, and I kinda like it. I don't know why. For this bedroom, I was also kinda lost, but then I was thinking, oh, maybe we can go for this orange bedding. But then after that, I feel like, oh my god, this is too hot. Why is it too warm? Because everything is just orange and yellow, and later I'm going to change the wallpaper into green, and you guys can see that. Yeah, that makes it so warm and still cozy but not too hot. It just looks nice and beautiful in my opinion. I hope you guys like it too though. This is the master bedroom. It connects to the bathroom and also a walk-in closet. And right here, I'm just putting a couple of things on the console table. Is this console table? I don't know. I think it's a console table if I'm not mistaken. And I'm just overlapping the curtains here because I feel like it creates an interesting look, and it's kind of realistic, you know. Whenever you are in a real house, usually they will have the sheer curtain and then the blackout curtain on top of it. And for this bathroom, I tried to do something interesting with the bathtub there. I put an elevated platform and the double sink. This is actually a dream of mine. If I ever have a house in the future one day, I want to have a double sink if I have a partner by then. And yeah, this is the walk-in closet. It's quite minimal. It just has whatever you need because it's a closet. You cannot do anything. You cannot do too much about it. Maybe you can, but I keep it really simple for this because I don't know. Maybe it's already about 2 hours in when I was recording this, and I was like, oh, I want to finish this faster because it's getting so late. And now we're continuing to the public bathroom after this. I just put on a couple of lights so it's brighter in the house. I just use the same flooring, the same wallpaper. And yeah, that's pretty much it about the bathroom outside there. Nothing interesting. And this is the pantry area facing the laundry room. The laundry room is nice. It's quite spacious and you can do your laundry here, and I love the color in the end, the mix of the blue and also the orange wallpaper. Not wallpaper, but I don't know what to call it, if it's like wall painting? I don't know, the wall thingy. And this is, I'm just trying to make it interesting. I don't want to put too much painting on the wall, so I just go with the wallpaper from Eco Lifestyle. For this room, it looks a little bit more girly just because of the bedside table and the bedding, but it actually is, it looks quite neutral in my opinion. It has more yellow in it, which makes it warmer, but nothing too feminine because I planned to make it a girl's bedroom, but in the end I decided to keep it neutral. And this is the common bathroom, the third bathroom, the biggest bathroom. Oh my god, I don't know. I did the same thing with the platform and the elevated thingy. I make this bathroom into yellow colors, I believe. Yes, it's yellow with the blue because I love the blue and yellow. They're complementing each other very well. And oh my god, my phone notification. I'm sorry, I forgot to put it to silent. This is the kids' bedroom. This is going to be a bedroom for 2 kids, and I decided to go for this bunk bed from Eco Lifestyles. They are so beautiful, and also this dollhouse, which is also beautiful. I love it. I guess the theme of this house is warm and cozy. I tried to make all of my build warm and cozy, but I ended up with, you know, whenever I'm uploading it to everywhere, to the gallery, to YouTube, to Instagram, I don't know what kind of description I want to make. I always make it warm and cozy. And this is the movie room. I keep it fairly dark because in a movie room, you don't want it to be so bright. Otherwise, you won't be enjoying the movie so much. There's no window in here. We just keep it very simple and dark and comfortable. Put a couple of pillows on the sofa and also poofs at the end there, and I'm going to put in a couple of snacks on the table there, and also an extra blanket on the corner after this. Yeah, you guys can see there. And then I put this red light. I keep the lighting very minimum for this room because I guess that's realistic for a room. And after this, we're going to jump into the game, and I'm going to give you guys the grand tour because I always like seeing a house in first person perspective. Okay, so we are in my game now. I'm going to give you guys the grand tour. When you enter the house, it looks very minimum and plain, but when you look to your left, it's so warm and cozy. I love the color combination because the yellow and blue, I really love it. And also the accent green. This is the kitchen with the black splash mirror there. And this is the dining area, which is beautiful as well. I hope you guys like this one. And this is the living area, the first living area without the movie, without the TV. And also I put this sign right here because I was thinking that with Airbnb nowadays, they usually have a name for their own Airbnb. So whenever people take a pictures, other people will know where they were staying. This is the view to the outside. This is so beautiful in front of the mountain. And this is a couple of sitting area at the front, and also a couple of sitting area on this side. I also put a couple of planter boxes just to make it interesting. This is how the living area looks. I honestly love it, and I hope guests love it too. This is the pantry. And on your left, the first door is going to take us into this laundry. This laundry is very packed, and I put a couple of towels and tissue because when some things getting wet, you know, when the water is leaking or something, you have extra tissue and towel there. And this is a place where you can hang out and chill, but this area is more private because the way you enter this patio is through the laundry room. So I just thought that it's gonna be nice. And plus you can see it from the dining room. This is our master bedroom. It's very simple and minimalistic, but it's still looking nice. I mean, the color combination is very beautiful, and also the painting is beautiful. This is how it looks from the other side. It connects to the master bathroom, and the master bathroom is actually like this. It looks like this. I mean, I kind of like how it looks. You guys see, and how it connects to the walk-in closet. It makes the room very, very big, and it looks more grand. And the color combination here again, it's the yellow, orange, and green, and it looks beautiful. Apologize for the ceiling there, something is wrong. And this is your walk-in closet. I feel like this is looking very nice. It looks more quite private, but still nice. This is the stairs to go downstairs, and the downstairs is actually empty, so you guys can make it into whatever you like. And this is the common bathroom for your guests. Nothing much in this bathroom, just the sink and the toilet, and also the plant on the wall. This is the second bedroom. This room is a little bit more feminine just because of the pink. I don't know why pink is considered as feminine, but. And this is our bathroom. We have a shower, double sink in here, and also a toilet and a bathtub. And right here is the kids' bedroom. Very nice, very nice. Lots of toys, but still minimal. And this is the bunk bed from Eco Lifestyle, which I love and adore. Right here is the other door next to the laundry room. It's actually our movie room. Look at this room. This is how you would want your movie room to look like, right? It's dark, it's cozy, and it has a couple of snacks there. This is the back of our house. We have a barbecue, a sitting area there where you can eat and talk with your friends. And also we have this, I don't know, day beds, and also a couple of pillows on the left side there where you can chill, and also the pool where you can dip your feet into. So that's it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you guys like the house. And if you do, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and also don't forget to subscribe, and also leave any suggestion you may have in the comment section down below. That's it for today's video. I hope you guys are having a wonderful day wherever you are, and I will talk to you really, really soon. Bye bye.